جزاكم الله خير الجزاء.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله وكفى، والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، ولا سيما سيدنا محمد المصطفى صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله أهل الصفا وأصحابه أهل الوفا، وعلى من بآثاره مقتفى واهتدى. أما بعد، فالسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Without going too long in any saying anything, I am honored to be here amongst you, inshallah, and I plan and I made the niyyah to learn from you. So this is my niyyah, inshallah ta'ala, and that I benefit, inshallah, from you, and we both, inshallah, do mudhakara and remind each other with the love of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. I told Mawlana hafizahullah ta'ala that the best way today, since it's just, you know, at the beginning, but not because of the beginning, the middle and the end is always about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, you know, I said the best thing is after the dhikr of Allah, we begin with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, right? Didn't the poet said, بعد عز خدا بزرگ تو هي قصة مختصر؟ So let's end the story and we start with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that's it. People take long ways. They go this way. Some people go east. Some people go west. We go to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And with that, you can be secured. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. مَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهِ. Those who obey the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, they have obeyed Rasulullah. They have obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وآله. So today I would like for all of us to go through this beautiful qasida. It's called Al-Qasida Al-Muhammadiyya, to someone that is very dear to all the muhibbin of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The author, all of you know, Imam Busiri rahimahullah ta'ala, the author of the Burda. So he not only authored the Burda, he authored three important qasaid, many things actually, but among them Al-Burda. All of you, مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على النبي وآل البيت كلهم. Somebody is looking at me, he said, that's not how what he said. He says, على what? على الحبيب خير الخلق كلهم. Okay, I can give you a different version. على النبي وآل البيت كلهم. Because when you make salah on Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, don't ever take away the salah on the آل. So it's adab. Adab with the Al of Al al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Adab with Sayyidina Ali al-Murtada. Adab with Sayyida Fatima al-Zahra. Adab with Imam al-Hasan, Imam Hussein, that when we make salah on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, we don't leave them out. Because as-sahaba, al-hadith sahih, as-sahaba asked them, Ya Rasulullah, how do you teach us, how do we make salam on you? He says, say, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Ali Muhammad. So we, Mawlaya salli wa sallim, daiman abadan. Ala habibika khayr al-khalqi kullihimi, or my version, ala al-nabiyyi wa ali al-bayti kullihimi. So now we have a nabi, we have al bayt. And that's, you can go home and sleep comfortably now. Or you have, well, you know, you belong to these people. Al-Imam al-Busiri radiallahu ta'ala anhu had three things. Al-Burda had more than three, but the important ones had Al-Hamziyya, had Al-Muhammadiyya, this one is Al-Muhammadiyya, and he has also one called Al-Mudariyya. Beautiful qasaid. Beautiful qasaid. Qasid Al-Mudariyya. Ya Rabbi salli ala al-mukhtari min mudarin. From mudar. Lakin this is a short, sweet, but everything about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even if it's long, becomes sweet. Right? Anything you put the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in, it turns sweet. Therefore, you can sweeten your heart with the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and sweeten your tongue with the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and sweeten everything about you with the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa alihi. Because very simple, you all know this. I'm not telling you, this is not a lecture. So today we're not lecture, we're just talking. Casual talk. Secret, but not secret to you. عشاق المصطفى. If someone is a عاشق of the مصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم, محب of the مصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم, you know this already. Secret is this, but to remind me and you, anything that has the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is elevated. Anything that has to do with the name of Al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is elevated. I'll give you example. Mecca. Was it Mukarrama before? Mecca became Mukarrama. Al-Madina. Al-Madina is Munawwara. The Ummah of Rasulullah, kuntum khayra Ummah. So the Ummah is Mecca al-Mukarrama. Al-Madina was Yathrib, became Medina. Not only Medina, Munawwara binuri Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-Ummah, kuntum khayra Ummatin. You are the best Ummah. Al-Ashab, the best of Ashab. أصحابي كالنجوم أهل البيت تركت فيكم ما إن تمسكتم به لن تضلوا بعدي أبدا كتاب الله وعترتي The best of أهل البيت القرآن مهيمنا عليه is the superior book Everything that has to do with رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم becomes the best So therefore if your heart has the love of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم It also is elevated. If Allah elevates a donkey, the donkey of Al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know his name? Duldul. Duldul. The mule. Duldul, now we write in the books of Sirah, all the ulama write Duldul, the name of Duldul. Until the day of judgment, you will hear the name Duldul. Allah honored a mule because it's of its relation to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How about a human being who loves Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? A stick is honored because An-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam touched it. Everything that has to do with him is honored. So if you increase his dhikr on your tongue, you will also be elevated and you will be also honored. No different. Why? Even if it's not because of you, but because of the beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is honorable. So... This is Al-Muhammadiyya. And he says, Muhammadun ashraful a'rabi wal ajami. Muhammadun khayru man yamshi ala qadami. Which means Muhammad is the most honorable. Sallallahu. But wait. If you hear the name of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't let it go. I want to hear salat all the time. You hear the name Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muhammadun ashraful a'rabi wal ajami sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muhammadun sallallahu alayhi wa sallam khayru man yamshi ala qadami. Is the best one who ever walked. Anyone ever walked on this earth better than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa Al-Imam Zain al-Abidin, Ali ibn al-Husayn, al-Sajjad, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. When they put the chains around his neck and honorable body for Sham in Damascus, and then the people, the Shamis at that time, they didn't know who he is. Yazid and all these, the clan, the, you know, the gang. Thugs and all these people sitting there. Who is this man? Imam Zain al-Abidin was 20, 21 years old. Not that old. Young man. Al-Imam Zain al-Abidin looks to Yazid, tell him, Ya Yazid, allow me to speak a couple of words. No, he said, sit, you know, what do you mean allow you? The people around Yazid told him, Ya Amir, let him. ما قدر ما يحسن هذا الغلام. He's only a غلام, يعني young man. How much can he talk? He cannot talk much. Let him speak. You know, people sometimes like fitna. When there's, let him.